I'm one of the kids leads here at Granite United, and I am so pumped you decided to join us this morning. I have a question for you. What is your favorite movie? My favorite movie is The Goonies. I'm going to count to three, and I want you to shout out your favorite movie. You ready? One, two, three. Shout it out. Awesome. We're going to be continuing our series called Wise, and this week's big idea is how you can ask God for the right words. So, kids, we're going to be going into our worship song now called Move. Now, I want you to get up. I want you to get up and dance and move around and move to the music. Are you ready? Here we go.
Feel the wonder, say his name. Watch the darkness slip away. Put your power on display. Say goodbye to fear and shame.
How's it going? We have something really important to talk about today. Are you ready? We're talking about words. Did you know that the words we say are important to God? So are the things we choose not to say. Has your mom or dad ever asked you to do something, like clean up your toys, and you said no instead of yes? Or has anyone ever said something that made you feel bad? See? Our words are important. King Solomon, the wisest man who ever lived, knew this was true too. As king, he had to make a lot of hard decisions. One day, two women came to him very angry. They were fighting over a baby. They both said the baby was theirs, but that was impossible. Solomon knew one woman wasn't telling the truth, but he wasn't sure how to make the wise choice. Solomon thought and thought and thought. He prayed and prayed and prayed. And finally, God gave him the wisdom he needed to make the right decision. Solomon spoke to the women and solved the problem. The baby went home with his mom, and the whole kingdom was amazed at Solomon's wisdom. Just like Solomon asked God to help him say the right words, we can ask God for the right words too.
Are you okay? Why aren't you talking? This is basically a talk show. You have to talk. Oh no. So apparently Carl isn't talking today, so we have to figure out something to do. How about Mad Lib? Mad Libs are like stories we get to make up as we go. So I'll read the words we need, and you can fill in the blanks with whatever words you want. Right, you can't talk, so maybe we can act out the words? All right. Okay, so I need a name of a person. Is that T? Okay, I'm guessing the Queen of England? All right. Okay, give me an adjective, a word to describe something. Smelly, stinky, farty. All right, that's pretty weird. I think we need another adjective and a noun, a person, place, or thing. Wait, I don't know what I'm guessing yet. Flappy pumpkin? All right. All right, so now we need another adjective and a noun. Grumpy tree? Okay, last one. Give me a verb, an action. Skip? All right, let's hear the story you made. Once upon a time, the queen and I went to the park. On our way to the farty park, we saw a flappy pumpkin on a bike. We also saw a big grumpy balloon tied to the tree, so we skipped home.
Pumpkins can't ride bikes.
Well, look at you, you can talk.
I know, I just couldn't hold in any longer.
Well, why weren't you talking in the first place?
Well, Cassie, I messed up this morning.
You did? How?
Well, my mamaw told me to clean up my room this morning, and well, I didn't want to.
Yeah, I don't feel like cleaning my room sometimes either. So what happened?
Well, I said a bad word.
Really? What did you say?
Well, when she told me to clean my room, I said, no. I know.
Did you get in trouble?
A little.
Wow, you didn't choose the right word, did you?
I sure didn't. And that's why I wasn't talking. I figured if I don't talk, I won't make the same mistake and say the wrong word again.
Yeah, I get that. But I think there's better ways to go about it.
Really? How?
Well, think back to the time when King Solomon had the right words for those two women that were fighting.
Oh yeah, those two women that lived in the same house and both had brand new babies.
Yep, but unfortunately, one of the babies didn't live. But instead of telling the other woman, the lady switched the babies and took her friend's kid, who was still alive.
Man, that's really sad. But also kind of messed up.
Yeah, so when the mother woke up, she was so sad because she saw her baby wasn't living anymore. But she looked closely and realized it wasn't her baby. It was her friend's. But the other mother wouldn't admit what she had done, so they went to the King Solomon.
Yeah. Then King Solomon said to split the baby in two and give each half to one of the women, which is pretty weird and kind of terrible.
It is weird, but Solomon really didn't want to hurt the baby. It was a test. You see, the real mother of the living child begged King Solomon not to harm the baby. And she said it would be okay if the child went with the other woman, if it meant her child could live.
So that's how he knew he was telling the truth. Holy moly. Solomon is super wise.
He sure was. And the only reason he was so wise is because he asked God for wisdom, and that gave him the right words to say.
So you're telling me that we can ask God for the right words?
Yes. I'm also telling you, that's our big idea.
No way! Today's big idea is we can ask God for the right words.
So say it out loud on the count of three. One,
two,
three.
We can ask God for the right words! All right! We did it! Sounds good! Thanks for helping me understand, Cassie. That was a great story. Don't you think so? Cassie? She's not talking. Oh, because the words thing. I was doing that earlier. Okay, she's not going to say anything, so... see ya. Bye!
Hey everyone, we are so glad that you joined us this week. This week, we learned about how we can ask God for the right words. I have my friend Mindy here this week with me, and she's going to read our memory verse, James 1:5.
And the memory verse is, if any of you lack wisdom, he should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to him.
That was awesome. Now, we want to see videos of you guys reading your memory verse to us. So make sure that you send that in for us next week for our final week. Now, before you go, we have one more song, and it is called Here. So get up, get ready, and let's go.